getting out of this one. G'day guys, welcome to Lucy's channel, Lucy Lane, the Queen of Balmain. Today we're going to talk about getting the perfect pup. So just the other day we had a comment that was left on one of Lucy's videos that I wanted to address and kind of give my own opinion and experience behind this topic. So let's get into it. Hang on a sec, let me just jam my glasses on my head. My German Shepherd journey has been crazy. I'll probably have to make a video on it, but I've actually given my pup back to her breeder and now I'm going to get her back. You should feel so lucky. Lucy is an amazing girl. Not all of us get one like her right away. So what I want to do right away is break down the stereotype of getting the perfect puppy. Because let me tell you from my own experience with Lucy herself, there is no perfect pups. I'm gonna tell you all of the bad stuff that she's done. Lucy, man, I've lost sleep over the some of the things that Lucy has done over the last 2.5 years of bringing her up. Now, don't get me wrong. Lucy's an extremely highly trained, versatile, well-mannered German Shepherd. But it hasn't always been this way. It's been a marathon of a journey from the day we got her to now, and we are still working on things. In my opinion, I'm lucky with Lucy with a few aspects. I'm lucky that she is genetically sound. She has good genetics thus far. We have had no complications with any types of hip dysplasia and things like that. I am lucky that her temperament, she has a well-balanced temperament. She's not aggressive, she's not fearful, she's confident. I'm lucky with these traits. Now, the last thing I want to do is paint a picture that these German Shepherd dogs are easy to handle, and then you just can go get the perfect pup, pop it in the backyard, you're good to go. You're just going to live this awesome life and have this beautiful relationship with this dog. Unfortunately, that's not the case. I kind of like to think a relationship with the German Shepherd is kind of like going to the gym. So the work you put in is what you get out of it. The time and effort you put into going to the gym are the results that you're going to get. And that is practically the same thing with one of these pups. If you get one of these dogs and you bring it home, but you don't do any work with it and it just kind of goes in the backyard and you go about your day, you're going to have a very unpleasant time. The dog's gonna get frustrated. You're gonna get frustrated. It's gonna destroy everything. It's probably going to try to big dog you and see where it sits in the pack, and everything goes very pear-shaped very quickly. And this is when it goes to these German Shepherds getting rehomed and all sorts of things like that. So the last thing that I wanna do with this German Shepherd channel is set the tone that owning a German Shepherd is a real easy walk in the park. Now, this comment that I got before isn't the first type of comment like that. I've actually received an email before being blamed for an individual who purchased a German Shepherd and realized very quickly that they didn't get a Lucy dog. And so I don't wanna paint the picture that it's complete sunshine and rainbows 24/7, especially at the start, because I can tell you what, it wasn't. I think out of all the German Shepherd puppies that I know, Lucy was probably the naughtiest out of all of them. So the first big mishap that Lucy had was causing a couple of $1,000 worth of damage to the backyard. I put all this time and training into training her inside, being the perfect pup inside the house, that I didn't put the same effort into training her outside in the backyard. I kind of gave her free rein, and as soon as I gave her enough rope, she hung herself and hung me because my wife went crazy. So that's the first big mistake that I made, which led to Lucy deconstructing the entire backyard to the point we had to get a builder in to repair fence lining, handrails, staircases, trees, garden beds, you name it, Lucy had destroyed it. So another behavioral issue that we had at about 8 or 9 months old was when Lucy decided to take the world's biggest wee on our bed. Now, this led to my wife and I having to sleep in the lounge room for the next week because we had to get the Wii dry cleaned out of our fairly new and very expensive king size mattress. Now, with this, as we got it dry cleaned, we were informed by the dry cleaner that the smell of the urine is penetrated so deep into the fabric that sometimes in the Australian summer, because the humidity is so high here in the summertime, that the urine will be reactivated by the humidity and will forever be graced with the smell on odd days every now and then of Lucy's pee. And to this day, now that we're coming into summer, every now and then you do get a whiff of it. So we do disguise it with lovely candle smells and things like that. But that's another thing that Lucy's done. And that was due to my incompetence, not reading signals at the time, and kind of learning as I went. Now, another thing that I went through with Lucy was Lucy stealing food. Now, not stealing food out of the cupboard or taking her food out of a bowl when she wasn't given permission to. Lucy was stealing, or went through this rebellious phase of trying to steal food off people at the park, which she successfully did twice. So the first time was some lovely young guy sitting at the park eating a Subway sandwich. Lucy ran straight up and took it off him. A few months later, the same thing happened again. There was a family in the off-lead dog park area having a picnic, but still, it's not just an off-lead dog area. It's obviously meant for families as well. Lucy went over and stole a kebab. Lucy has a really super high food drive and also a super high toy drive. So at the time, she went through this phase of thinking, if I find it, because dogs are scavengers, if I find it, I can take it. Obviously, I had to correct these issues. We went back to basics. We took some steps back when it came to obedience training, redressed some problems that I was having, and then we kept moving forward. Other crazy things Lucy used to do was whenever Lucy would find a dead animal, particularly rats around here, she would love to eat them. Now, this scared the hell out of me because as soon as she found a dead rat, all of her training would go out of the window and she would try to wolf it down as quickly as she could. Now, a lot of the rats around here are dead because they've been poisoned. They've obviously eaten rat bait up in the homes around here, and then the rats do come out. The rat bait makes them try to look for water. They drink the water and they pretty much swell up and die. Now, this can essentially be passed on to an animal that consumes the flesh of an animal that's been poisoned. So this was practically one of my biggest fears a little while ago when Lucy went through this phase of trying to eat every small dead animal that she'd find. So when you're looking for a German Shepherd, you must get out of your head that you're looking for the perfect pup, because you will be disappointed. You can't just get a puppy straight off the shelf most of the time and just be like, hey, I'm gonna have a Lucy dog. It's gonna be perfect, because I can tell you what, that's not gonna be the case. To get Lucy to the point where she's at now has taken me 2.5 years of absolute commitment. Every single day being kept on my toes. Every single thing we do has taken time to get to that point. Even to get Lucy to sit on the chair and look at the camera, that took time and that took training. So the reason why I'm sharing with this with you guys is just so you know, there are no perfect pups out there. There are a lot of good puppies out there. You know what? All of them are good puppies. Most of them are good puppies, but there are no perfect puppies. When you go and pick up your new German Shepherd because you may have been inspired from, you know, you may be seeing a couple of cool photos on Instagram or maybe watched one of our videos, just understand that there's a lot of work that goes behind this pup, okay? And she's still far from perfect. So to get Lucy to the point where I can kind of start to relax and, you know, let my hair down a little bit with her, it's 2.5 years later of very structured routine and training, dedication, blood, sweat and tears, sleepless nights, lots of money, lots of things destroyed. Yes, Lucy has a lot of great qualities about her. Don't get me wrong. You know, she has a zest for life. She learns fast. She's easy to train. She's very obedient. You know, there's a lot of great characteristics of her as well. With those characteristics of wanting to learn, having a decent prey drive, willing to work, that can also be a bad thing if that attention isn't put in the right direction. So guys, I just wanted to make sure that you guys understand, especially for people who are looking at getting a German Shepherd, because I see the comments all the time. Lucy's not perfect. The job wasn't easy. Yeah, it's a life long commitment. And there's gonna be a lot of bad times. There's gonna be a lot of amazing times, but you gotta take the good with the bad. And that's just how it is. I wouldn't trade Lucy for the world. She would trade me for a piece of chicken in a heartbeat. There's no doubt about that. But that's just life. So guys, if you enjoyed this video, please hit the thumbs up. Drop a comment below. Let us know your thoughts or your journey. If you're looking at getting a German Shepherd, or if you have a German Shepherd, was the journey what you thought it would be, or was it completely different? I'd love to hear it in the comments. Guys, have a rocking week. Be productive, stay safe, and we'll see you in the next video.